Grip of Resting Thoughts is one of the endgame grind spots in the game, and this is where you get the Deboreka belt. I have spent 20 hours in this grind spot, and these are the results. But before that, let's talk about the requirements and the things that we need to prepare in order to be efficient in this dungeon. This grind spot requires you to have 300 AP and 400 DP. This grind spot has an AP limit of 830, and beyond that, 70% of the exceeded AP will be applied, unlike LVA grind spots where you only get 5% of the exceeded AP. Also, this grind spot is not profitable unless you sell the Deboreka belt, so bear that in mind. I am a 730 gear score Awakening Guardian. For my artifact, I'm using the Wild Camasylvia, which gives me plus 30 extra damage to Camasylvian monsters. For the magic crystals, I highly recommend using stun resistance because you will die if you get stunned. And also, having a 100% stun resistance makes the grind smoother and you don't have to worry about getting stunned. This is my skill add-on. This is specifically designed for my own combo rotation, and feel free to change the skill add-on however you like. For the combo rotation that I'm using, there's a link in the description down below. The mob in this grind spot are incredibly tough and has a high evasion rate. In my case, I have around 900 plus accuracy with buffs, consumables, and furniture buffs. This grind spot requires you to use an elixir rotation with a fairy with a skill called Continuous Care 4, which auto uses 16 consumables such as elixirs and perfumes. These are the elixirs that I'm using. As for the perfume, you can either use a Kalx elixir or Perfume of Courage, but for me, I'm using the Kalx elixir for the extra defense, and also Perfume of Courage is way too expensive. As for the food buff, I'm using a simple crown mail for the plus 30 AP against monsters. Also, do not forget your church buff and tent buff. For the furniture buff, I'm using the Goblin Chief helmet, which gives me plus 20 to accuracy. You can also use the Imp Boss's Knife, which gives plus 15 AP for 1 hour. The reason why I'm using the Goblin Chief helmet is because I don't have Imp Boss's Knife. As for the item drop rate, I'm using the Tent buff for the plus 50% item drop rate, the Camasylvian buff, which gives plus 20% item drop rate, Node Investment Benefits plus 10% item drop rate, the Global Blessing of Earth buff, which gives plus 20 item drop rate, and a yellow loot scroll. All in all, I have a total of 250% to 300% item drop rate depending on the global buff, and also, as of the making of this video, there is an item drop rate event and the double global boss buff event, which gives plus 40% item drop rate instead of 20%, so consistency is just not applicable. As long as you have 250% plus item drop rate, then you are good to go. For the rotation, I always go counterclockwise. I also avoid this specific pack because there are only 5 mobs, and it is just not worth it. Also, when stacking mobs, do not go for more than 10 because you'll just burn your durability, which is the biggest issue in this grind spot. I don't have a pay-to-win tent, so to solve that issue, I just used all of my saved up brand stones and used them on all of my accessories. If you don't have a pay-to-win tent or brandstones, then you can craft a sealed Old Moon Camping anvil which lasts for 24 hours. The anvil can be crafted in Tarif and the materials are easily obtained. You can either buy all of them in the central market or just grind them. You'll also encounter mini bosses in this grind spot, so be extra careful because the mini boss deals significant amount of damage and can knock you down. After grinding this area for 20 hours, these are the results. Thank you for watching and have a nice day.